we're here at the exclusive viewing. Everyone's out here, you know what I'm saying? We're having a little break now. We just watched four of the clashes, man. Energetic, everyone enjoyed it, you know. Bit of laughs, bit of jokes in there, bit of serious moments, tense moments. So we're just here, man, enjoying it. We're gonna go backstage after. Man made me
hold that six,
yeah. You know what it is, yeah. P Mania, hold that Gino, yeah. Man made me say we're backstage, you know. I see it. My brain glitched. I didn't know what was going on. Yeah, but we're here, man. We enjoyed the day. Everyone was watching it, man, and just vibes in. We're gonna go back in and spit some bars, and we're just here. You get me? Catch some footage and know what's going on. Shouts to P. We're here. You know what I'm saying? The next move we're making is legendary. You know what it is? The Big H movement with P Money. That's gonna shut down the whole of England. So I know everyone's excited about that. So just stay tuned. You know what it is? BRMG. Boy, better know. Shut up.
Little Nasty versus Match, though, it was quite funny still. Temperatures was flaring, you get me? People go and get the DVD, man. You get me?
Matting. Make sure you cop it, car. That's probably one of the best ones still. I'm saying, I like Little Nasty's, like, hoodness, innit? Like, it's hard. It's hood, innit? But Max has got some sick wordplay as well, man. They're both hard, innit, in their own ways, but it's a big clash, man, trust me. I can't really say there's any winner, truthfully. Just kicks off, fam. It's madness, Max, though. Make sure you watch it, bam.
Max the Little Nasty, yeah? Obviously, things were popping, you get me? You see Little Nasty, yeah, you get me? When I hear his bars, as me, as an MC, I'm like, shh. Like, the way he puts bars together, I can tell that he's been in it for a long time. Like, I can tell he's been in this. He's reached levels. He's surpassed levels, surpassed guys. Obviously, yeah, and Max, yeah, for a young guy, yeah, coming out swinging, like everybody knows Max is hard, like we all know Max is hard, you get me? And he's coming out, yeah, and like a lot of fire went down, you get me? Like a few things got blanked out, like obviously certain things like ain't allowed to be said on there, you get me? Like certain personal things, you get me? But obviously, yeah, you just gotta hold your composure, you get me? Because when you come to a clash, you gotta expect, obviously, Villain, he's been on a few clash things, you get me? And his clash thing, yeah, it's my dog Villain, you get me? Invasion alert. Obviously, and he knows, you get me? Sometimes anything can get said, you get me? And you've just got to hold your composure. Because if you're like, and then you go, then that's like, yeah, man, like, yo, it can be an illegal punch, but you still got knocked out, you get me? Man, it's still like, yo, my man's knocked out on the floor, you get me? So no matter what gets said, you got to hold your composure. By the end of the day, you get me? Like, swingers to the end, bro. Fucking Rocky Balboa versus Apollo Creed, you get me? Like, yo, anybody won that, fam. Like, they were both swinging out, you get me? But, yo, it was a big clash, you get me? So make sure you buy Lord of the Mics 5, yeah?
I think both of them went in. Obviously, there were some things that happened that it kind of slowed down the clash, as in things weren't allowed to be said and that, so the pressure on both of them, it's like, I know both of them could have just spazzed out, but you get me? Yeah, man. And obviously at the end, I think Little Nasty said something about Max's brother, innit? And then it was like, it was a good thing and a bad thing, like, you get me? But in Nasty's sake, it would be a good thing that he said it in the clash, because it's like giving him one up in a clash to win. But saying it is like you made Maxstar just like you touched a nerve, so he went in a bit more, as in angriness and that, you know what I'm saying? So
he took it. I'm gonna be honest, yeah. I think it was, I don't know, it was a tough one. Max has got bars. Look, on the clash, yeah, I think Lil Nasty done his thing, but no, wait. But yeah, it was a draw. They had pros and cons, you get me, for either side. But yeah, they both done their thing. That Max had some cheeky ones, so they're a little nasty.
Okay, he started off funny, then it kind of got intense, where you felt like someone was gonna kill someone or something. Like I felt like I was in a room, you get me? Like, felt the pressure. Yeah, it was a sick clash, man.
I think it was sick, you know? It was fun, I had a good time. I believe I won, I had faith in myself. It was a tense moment. But I came out of the basement with my head held high. And so for that, I feel like a winner, you know what I'm saying? What did I say to Max when he walked away? Some hurtful stuff, you know, I obviously touched the nerve. If you follow me on Twitter and all that, I'll be saying what was mentioned when I got censored, you know what I'm saying? That's at LILNASTY UK. Yeah. yeah, I took it deep, you know what I'm saying? But that's the whole point of a clash, if you, you know, there's no boundaries, no rules, no limits.
Little Nasty versus Maxter, Maxter versus Little Nasty, three rounds. I have to say, personally, as a UK DJ, two rounds went to Maxter, but the third final round, Little Nasty took it, he destroyed him. And the only problem that I had, that I think is not fair, and I think, Gemma, you should need to sort this out, no mobile phones are allowed. No mobile phones are allowed. You need to come into this battle talking about how you feel and how you are as an artist. By looking at the mobile phones, it's not a good thing. That's my views of the whole Lords of the Mic. But overall battle, Little Nasty, I salute you. Maxter, definitely support you as well. But my verdict goes to Little Nasty.
Yeah, nah. Personally, yeah, I think Maxter took round one. Yeah, like personally, I think he took round one. But after, Nasty just destroyed him. Like lyrically, like content-wise, Maxter was alright, but Nasty had a lot more lyrics. You know what I'm saying? He just made man look a bit pathetic.
I think he had more of a story. Then Maxter was
it was more aimed at Maxter. You know what I'm saying? Like Max's lyrics weren't all aimed at Nasty.
Like that cash was sick, so sick. I had to fucking tweet both of them and tell them, yo, that cash was sick, bro. It was going in, bro. It was sick, man. What's the verdict? Right, sir. I think Lil Nasty took it, you know, just edged it. I think he edged it. You know what, Maxter, he's reading off his phone. Like, I think Lil Nasty edged it still. Yeah?
Say that. The big main event, Maxter, Lil Nasty, it got very heated and personal. You know what I'm saying? It really did, innit?
No, I want to know about the uncut footage, innit? For Maxter and Nasty, I want to see the uncut footage because there was a reason. Most of the clashes, Jamma got in the middle and said, okay, that's the end of the round, so on and so forth. That certain clash, for some reason, they cut away and they put a logo in the middle. So I'm very sure that there was some kind of stuff going on. I hope they show the uncut footage on the DVD. You know, I'm going to cop that.